what's up everybody, today we're going to go over what you should do when you go pond hopping. You should have a bottom bait. This is a football head jig, right there. You should have a moving bait. I particularly have a crankbait. You can use a jerkbait if you want, but I have crankbait. You want Texas rig, Senko, usually. You want a drop shot. A drop shot right here. Right there, you got a little drop shot. The weight. And if you want, you can have an alternate pole. My alternate pole is this little Ned rig. And now beside the poles, you want to have some sort of box. I just have this little drawstring in the side pocket. Got some pliers. You always need some pliers just in case it gets too deep. A knife. And some scissors. Now, what do you want in your little tackle bin? This is all the hard baits right here. Well, so I got some chatter baits, different colors. I got black and blue and white chartreuse. You want some swim jigs. So I got the box of chatter baits, swim jigs. You want football head jigs. You want some alternate hatch spins or something like that, underspins. You want some, personally I like swim baits, so swim bait hooks. So popper, just in case you want to do some popping. Then you got some bullet weights in case you want to do a Texas rig. Now you want some crankbaits. I got this one, yellow perch color. This is kind of a bluegill color. And then you always want a lipless crankbait. Then you could have, you should have jerkbaits. I've got this yellow and green jerkbait. Underneath we got this white and purple. Both are kind of shad. Now I also have this cheap one, which will still work well. This Rapala yellow perch type color. Yeah, this is the tackle box. It doesn't really need a lot if you're doing pond hopping. Now you need some soft plastic. So you should get some craws, crawdads, some 5-inch Senkos, some more craws in different colors. You need some sort of line right there, just in case you break off or something and you lose too much line. Some swim baits. You need a little snack. You need some drop shot. This is some more swim baits. So, in the end, we got your bottom bait, moving bait, Ned rig, Texas rig, drop shot. You got your little main tackle box. You got some bullet baits, crank baits, jerk baits, football head jigs, swim jigs, chatter baits, a popper, some swim bait stuff, swim bait hooks, underspin jig heads. Right there, got some line. You got some 5-inch Senkos, some drop shot, swim baits, some more swim baits, a little snack, crawdads, some more crawdads. Oh yeah, we also have scissor, pliers, knife. So that's what you should bring pond hopping. See you next time.
I can make a living off of turning in bass. Worry about the price of gas. Other way, I'm dealing. Sitting there reeling on me. Hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's a prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting, fishing, and loving every day. In the morning, late in the evening, I'm getting ready to reach the hammering pain. Hunting, fishing, loving every day.
Alright, we're done. Finally. Oh my god, it's on.
On a hill, looking at a field downwind. If I can make a nickel off of turning in bass, never worry about the price of gas. I'll be wheeling and dealing and sitting there reeling them in. Hunting, fishing, loving every day. That's the prayer that a country boy prays. Thank God he made me this way. Hunting and fishing and loving every day. Early in the morning, late in the evening, I'm getting red dirt rich and Flint River paid. Hunting, fishing, and loving every day.